Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Dr. Clear Hugh. If you are new here, namaste. My name is Dr. Rakshita and this channel is all about skincare, wellness and makeup. So if any of these interest you, don't forget to subscribe. So guys, in today's video we will be talking about the underrated sunscreen. This one, I had a lot of requests for this particular sunscreen and I was wondering why, and then I realized it's probably because of the affordability factor and then there's some hype around it. So I'm going to talk about this. We are going to discuss all the ingredients in here, what my experience was with this product and whether or not I recommend it. And now without any further ado, let's get straight into the video. Acha, so let's quickly discuss the sun filters in here. The first one is octin oxate, which is a UVB sun filter. Then the second one is avobenzone, which is a UVA sun filter. And then there's benzophenone 3, which is a hybrid sun filter. That means it provides both UVA and UVB sun protection. Now, what are UVA, UVB and UVC rays? Now, there's three type of UV rays. Like I said, UVC rays are blocked by the ozone layer, so we don't have to worry about them. But UVA rays and UVB rays enter the environment and can penetrate the skin, and they cause skin aging, skin burning and different types of skin cancers. So we have to, you know, protect ourselves from these different types of UV rays. Now guys, on the website I couldn't find the, you know, the lab result of the UV factors, but I DM'd them on Instagram and they got back to me with the lab certificate of the given SPF and PA values, and I'll insert it somewhere right here. Now on the packaging itself, it says critical wavelength 377.7 nm. now critical wavelength of a sunscreen means at what critical wavelength does a sunscreen allow 10% of UV rays to enter your skin, and a critical wavelength of 370 nm above is considered to be excellent protection. So the fact that this is 377 makes it really, really nice. Now talking about some other ingredients in here, most of the ingredients are simply emollients. Like for example, there's this Radicare Gold, which is basically like a compound of some different ingredients mixed. Most of the ingredients in that are sunflower oil, tocopherol, beta carotene and what's this, Crambe Abyssinian seed oil. I don't know how to pronounce that, but basically another seed oil. Then there's a bunch of like caprylic triglyceride is in here. Then we have hydrogenated castor oil as well. We have butylene glycol, we have propinidiol, we have bunch of different types of viscosity controllers or like heavy emollients. So this sunscreen, at least ingredient list wise, sounds like it's gonna be a heavy sunscreen, but just hold on, I'll tell you what it is like. Now the sunscreen also has fragrance in the ingredients list, so if you are someone that's either allergic to fragrance or has like an inflammatory skin condition like active acne or eczema or psoriasis or even really bad rosacea, fragrance might not be something you'd want to use. Otherwise, I don't mind fragrance. I personally use fragrance all the time, so I wouldn't, you know, like I don't mind fragrance, so I wouldn't stop you from using products with fragrance unless you are someone who's either allergic or has an inflammatory skin condition. Now I will of course include a texture shot like I always do, where I'm going to be showing you what this sunscreen looks like on my face in particularly when applied. Now this sunscreen has zero white cast, it has no white cast at all, and the finish of the sunscreen on my skin, first it goes on like a thick lotion, so it settles down to a more shiny dewy finish, but then give it 5 more minutes and it starts settling into this more matte finish, but not exactly matte, but a more natural dewy. Not matte, but it, I don't know how to explain it, but it starts to mattify and then the last finish from dewy comes down to a bit more natural glowy, so it doesn't look very, very shiny on the skin. Now the texture, I'll right now in the camera, I'll show you what I'm talking about. There's something different about the texture where I feel like this sunscreen is a bit tacky. I'll quickly just show you what I mean. I hope on the camera you could see those peaks forming as I was doing this to the sunscreen, which reminded me of snail mucin, but it's not that sticky. Also, like snail mucin is really slippery sticky, it's not like that, but it does have that tackiness to it which eventually settles down. Like I said, it starts to mattify, so that tacky finish settles down into a very comfortable, more powdery finish somehow. Now With this sunscreen, what my opinion on this is the fact that this is a more heavier sunscreen. Doesn't feel heavy. By heavy, I don't mean it feels heavy, but by heavy as in it's quite moisturizing. So someone with extremely oily skin that breaks out very easily and is the face is just like really oily, I feel like this would be a bit heavy. Like my own face is extremely oily, acne prone, and hence I feel like this sunscreen would be a perfect fit for me during the winters. But during the summers, I feel like this will be extremely heavy on my skin. On the other hand, someone with more drier skin would genuinely enjoy this. Like your skin won't feel dry, it will feel super moisturized once you've put this sunscreen on. For me personally, I avoid putting a moisturizer before this. I put this straight on. I still feel like it pulls a bit more moisturizing on my skin. So during winters, I'd really, really enjoy it. But for drier skin types, I feel like this is the perfect sunscreen you were looking for. There can't be a better one than this. Having said that, I did not see this sunscreen claim to be water or sweat resistant. So it is definitely not that. I did not personally try it out like running my hand under the tap. But it doesn't claim to be water or sweat resistant. So if you're someone that wants like a water sweat resistant sunscreen, this is not gonna be that one. So for that, I'm gonna cut one mark. So and another mark I'm gonna cut for it being a little too moisturizing actually for like really oily skin types. So my rating for this sunscreen is gonna be an 8/10. I definitely recommend it for if you're an oily skin type more during the winters, and if you're more dry to normal skin type, you would really, really enjoy using this during the like all year round actually. And if you're a more combination skin type, I feel like you'll also get away with it. But if your combination skin leans a bit more towards oily, then you can probably preserve it for the winters, and I feel like it's gonna do wonders during the winters. Having said that, I did not experience any burning on my face, which sometimes when your skin's sensitive or if you're using actives, your skin can really tingle and burn if you're using a chemical sunscreen. Didn't do that. It didn't sting my eyes at all. I felt really, really comfortable after applying this sunscreen. So that issue I did not encounter. With that, we have reached the end of today's video. If you like the video, don't forget to like the video. Don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.